Hello everyone, this is Nishtha Srivastav, legal intern under Lexis & Company, and today I am here to discuss the ways in which different derivative instruments help in mitigating the loss of the investors incurred in the securities market. However, the most important part in this entire topic is first to understand what derivative instruments actually are. So derivative is an agreement or a contract between two parties wherein the price is derived from the value of another asset. These another assets may be debt or equity, securities, both of them. When the price of the underlying changes, the value of derivative also changes. As far as the life term of a derivative instrument is concerned, the total life of a derivative is for a period of maximum 3 years. However, exceptions like a Nifty options contract has a term of 5 years. Now, it's important to discuss what are the various types of derivative instruments that we are offered in the securities market. The first is forwards and futures. So forwards and futures are actually financial contracts that obligate the contract's buyers to purchase an asset at a pre-agreed price on a specified future date. Both forwards and futures are essentially the same in their nature. However, forwards are more flexible because the parties can customize the underlying commodity as well as the quantity of the commodity and the date of the transaction. On the other hand, futures are standardized contracts that are traded on the exchanges. Moving on, our second instrument that is offered as a derivative instrument by the securities market is the options. Options are a very popular form of derivative instruments. These provide the buyer of the contracts the right but not the obligation to purchase or sell the underlying asset at a predetermined price. Based on the option type, the buyer can exercise the option on the maturity date or at any date before the maturity. Across the globe, there are two popular kind of options that are offered by the European Stock Exchange and the American Stock Exchange. The European options are the ones wherein the buyer can exercise it on the maturity date. But in the American Stock Exchange, the American options are those wherein the buyer can exercise his option at any time before the maturity. Third, swaps. Swaps are derivative contracts that allow the exchange of cash flows between two parties. Swaps usually involve the exchange of a fixed cash flow for a floating cash flow. The most popular type of swaps are interest rate swaps, commodity swaps, and currency swaps. Now, what are the actual advantages of derivatives? Unsurprisingly, derivatives exert a significant impact on modern finance because they provide numerous advantages. Let's discuss that. The first one is hedging risk exposure. Since the value of derivative is linked to the value of the underlying asset, contracts are primarily used for hedging risks. What does hedging mean? Let's take an example. For example, an investor may purchase a derivative contract whose value moves in the opposite direction, maybe in the direction of a loss, to the value of an asset the investor owns. In this way, profits in the derivative contract may offset the losses in the underlying asset. Second, underlying asset price determination. Derivatives are frequently used to determine the price of the underlying asset. For example, the spot prices of the futures can serve as an approximation of a commodity price. Third, market efficiency. It is considered that derivatives increase the efficiency of financial markets. How do they do this? By using derivative contracts, one can replicate the payoff of the asset. Therefore, the prices of the underlying asset and the associated derivative tend to be in equilibrium to avoid arbitrage opportunities. Fourth, access to unavailable assets or market. Derivatives can help organizations get access to otherwise unavailable assets or markets. By employing interest rate swaps, a company may obtain a more flexible rate of interest relative to the rate of interest available from direct borrowing. However, as every coin has two sides, so has derivatives. So there are certain disadvantages despite the benefits the derivatives bring to the financial markets. The drawbacks resulted in disastrous consequences, especially during the global financial crisis of 2007 and 2008. The rapid devaluation of mortgage-backed securities and credit default swaps led to the collapse of financial institutions and securities around the world. Now let's just discuss them. The first is high risk. The high volatility of derivatives exposed them to potentially huge losses. The sophisticated design of the contracts makes the valuation procedure extremely complicated or even impossible in certain conditions. Therefore, they bear a high rate of risk. Second, speculative features. Derivatives are widely regarded as a tool of speculation. Due to extremely risky nature of derivatives and their unpredictable behavior, unreasonable speculation may also lead you to huge losses. Third, counterparty risk. Although derivatives traded on the exchange generally go through a due diligence process, some of the contracts traded over the counter do not include a benchmark for due diligence. Thus, there is a possibility of counterparty default. Thus, this is the way how derivatives help the investors in order to mitigate their losses, and that's what about this video was. Thank you.